Happy morning. Today's topic is about lightning and it's part of a thermal death. And here a lightning is mean a flash or a bolt of lightning. It is due to an electric discharge from a cloud to a air. And here the electric current is directed with a potential of about 20,000 amperes and about 1,000 to 1,000 million volts or even more. And a lightning differs from ordinary electric current injuries in terms of degree. And here death is inevitable. Death is usually caused by high voltage direct current due to a cardiopulmonary arrest or an electrothermal injuries. And these are the salient features about lightning. And here in atmospheric electric discharge, a leader of a bolt of lightning can travel at a speed of 220,000 km per hour, and the time required to pass on earth lies between in microseconds, and in temperature it is about 50,000 centigrade, and based on ampere where lightning produces highest amount of currents, and it is greater than lies between 12,000 to 20,000 amperes. At autopsy, where a dead body has been brought for, and here we could lie in a remote area or on an open field or on a highway, where body shows only features of contusion, lacerated and fracture injuries on those parts, and it may mimic like a homicidal death. And if there been a documental history provided by the IVO or by the relatives where he has been in the open field or for an agriculture purpose or some other purpose, and there been a history of thunderstorm in that locality, and evidence of lightning in the vicinity of the body can be the other clue. And here only by in a proper external examination and by seeing the features of injury that are more likely by lightning, like linear burns, surface burns, or on a filigree burns, or otherwise any extreme burns or metallization of objects within the belongings of the individual, and by which were circumstantial evidences that suggestive of there being a possible lightning injury, and by rule outing other natural causes of death wherein a final opinion can be arrived. On the external examination, where clothes that have been worn by the individual may be burnt completely or partially, and the maximum burn can be noted at a point of entry or point of exit of a lightning injury. And as a result of a burn over the clothes, where the underlying body part may or may not show associated burns, and in extreme degrees of lightning injury where there may be multiple torns as a result of the wind of the lightning, or it may be even stripped off from the individual, and rarely it remains undamaged. And especially the metallic buckles, the belt buckles and the zipper of the clothes may show features of melting effect. And coming to the objects that have been present in the individual's pockets, and here most commonly the metallic objects and the plastic objects. And examples for metallic objects like a coin or on a pen knife, or even in cases where there been a nail cutter where those appears to be molten, fused together as a result of magnetizing effect of the lightning injury, where it may serve as a clue to exposure. and regarding the plastic objects like a pen or on a credit card or on a cell phone may be completely molten and completely distorted. Coming to linear burns, and in linear burns, especially the moist areas, the folds of the skin, or just example, just beneath the breast or down of mid chest and mid axillary region, will the areas of linear burns. And regarding the length, it varies from 3 to 30 centimeter or even more, with 0.3 to 2.5 centimeter. The tip of distribution of burns may suggestive of first or second degree of burns. And that regarding the time of development may be initial or even in later hours after a lightning stroke, and it appears like in a steam burns secondary to vaporization of the sweat, rainwater that has caused by a flashover phenomena on the victim's skin. Wound presentation may suggest of punctate burns, and here it will be multiple, closely spaced, and discrete circular burns can be noticed on the exposed body parts, and the diameter usually varies from few millimeters to 1 centimeter, and in cases of survival, their small graft may be required. And regarding to the depth of the wound, may be even full thickness or it may be even superficial, and in case of the superficial, it may even resembles like a secret burns. Other characteristic feature or on a pathognomic feature of a lightning injury is filigree burns. The synonyms for filigree burns are abrasion marks, Leidenberg flowers. And here the word filigree burns is a characteristic feature of a lightning injury, and here multiple superficial irregular tortuous marks that are seen on this exposed part of a body resembling like a branch of tree. The other names like fern burns or the other synonym to filigree burns. And here the fern-like pattern of erythema is seen on part of a skin, and most commonly noted over shoulder and the anterior aspect of chest region, and it is not associated with burning. And the mechanisms or theory that supports filigree burns are first and foremost a static electricity discharge along the superficial vasculature. Second, it is due to hemoglobin staining on the part of a tissue, and it almost appears like in a tree due to breakdown of RBCs within the capillaries. Third, it is in another theory which says that it is in a line of passage of current, and it is due to skin moisture. Fourth theory, it suggests that it is due to minute deposition of a copper in the skin. Yes, this is the anterior part of the chest region where we can able to see filigree burns, and here it almost looks like in a fern-like pattern or on a branch of a tree-like pattern, right? Classically seen over part of a shoulder region or on the part of the chest region. Feature of surface burns as a result of lightning injury. And here it has been caused as a result of external heat. And previously where linear burns, punctate burns, filigree burns, it has been caused as a result of endogenous heat. And here surface burns, it been resulted as a result of external heat or otherwise exogenous heat. And here, as a result, where an individual been exposed to a lightning, where victim's cloth goes to a state of burning, or otherwise the victim was carrying a metal or wearing a metal, can lead to a second or a third degree of burns to the adjacent site of a skin as a result of objects that become heated as rapidly by the electrical injury. Coming to mechanical lesions, and here, as a result of the wind of a lightning injury or on a blast like disruptive lesions that have been caused due to the expand of or as a result of displacement of air, can result in contusions, fractures, lacerations and wound of all kinds on the exposed body part. And here, fractures where can occur wherein a victim been thrown over, he can sustain fractures of skull, facial or in part of a limb. And lacerations not only on the external part of a body, where even internal organs can be subjected for laceration. And regarding the ears, where ears present as hemotympanum or as a result of a blast like wave can result in ruptures of tympanic membrane. Of lightning injury are brain shows features of congestion and features of edema can be noted. And regarding hemorrhages, where there have been skull fractures or associated fractures as a result of wind effect, where victim may be thrown from the site towards different parts, and according to the external objects that have been presented, he can suffer from epidural, subdural hemorrhage or subarachnoid or intracerebral hemorrhages. And basal ganglia hemorrhages and brainstem hemorrhages can be even fatal. And leptomeninges may show features of congestion and lacerated injuries. And regarding lungs, features of congestion, patchy hemorrhages on undersurface of pleura can be detected. And regarding muscles, features of necrosis, myoglobinuria, renal failure can be the other features regarding muscles. Regarding blood vessels, where blood vessels may show features of thrombosis, and in extreme forces it can also result in a rupture of blood vessels. Regarding eardrum and ear, where external hemorrhages or rupture of tympanic membrane or a hemorrhage within the middle ear can be noticed. Coming to the cause of death, and here there have been an involvement of central nervous system can result in paralysis of a heart or in a respiratory pathway that has been compromised, or otherwise electrothermal injuries that occurred as a result of lightning may be the cause of death. Points of importance: 50% of people who have been struck by lightning have been dead. And here, regarding the manner, it is always accidental in nature. And thirdly, it may mimic like a homicidal death, when a dead body that has been recovered from an open space or from a highway with features of contusion, fractures and lacerations of internal as well as the external organs, which may even mislead the case. And in here, to avoid those where a detailed history regarding and followed by meticulous external as well as internal examination of the deceased, whereby and in some cases where we may get a history of thunderstorm in that locality, and by seeing the patterns of injury on the external as well as the internal organs, whereby an autopsy surgeon can give an opinion as a lightning injury, and other associated features like burning of clothes and followed by metallization and fusion of the metallic objects within the materials that have been burned by the individual, and by only by correlation and ruling out other natural causes of death where the opinion of lightning injury can be given as a final opinion. Thank you so much for your patient listening. If there have been doubts, queries related to the content of this video, kindly address those issues in comment section below or otherwise through the social media links that have been provided in description section. Thank you.